Whoa, Mary Poppins got fancy. But before we talk about Emily Blunt and our first look at her as the iconic character, the iconic Disney character, although P.L. Travers would pick a bone with that. If you have not seen Saving Mr. Banks, do yourself a favor and watch it. It is not only integral to understanding the Mary Poppins story, both, you know, the movie and behind the scenes and the importance of it, but it's one of my three top movies of all time. But anyway, I'll tell you right now that while I'm not sure that if that looks like Mary Poppins, that sure as heck looks like 17 Cherry Tree Lane in front of her. That's so exciting! It looks just like the house from the 1964 movie. I just saw Beauty and the Beast. As I said in my review there, it's pure Disney magic that I had said I had not seen the likes of in a live-action Disney film since Mary Poppins, and so I'm very excited to see if Disney can capture that magic again as well. You know what's weird to me? That Mary Poppins has a budget for new things, right? I would not expect Mary Poppins to replace things like a hat or a bag, right? She's always seemed quite frugal to me. Wasn't that the point of her lessons? Although she did carry that mirror around, right? But the fact that she, you know, shoes wear out, coats get holes in them, they lose their warmth. But hats and bags are pretty, you know, They stand the test of time. So the fact that Mary Poppins would want to stay in fashion, I guess, does stick with the character, as she was just a little bit vain in the movie, which was part of her charm. Absolutely fantastic. So she's traded in her flower bag for a bag that, to me, it looks, oh, I forget, Mackenzie Childs. It looks like she picked it up from Mackenzie Childs, quite frankly. Fun little store. Maybe they can do a promotional campaign with some merchandise. But it also has like a little bit of an Art Deco feel to it. It definitely, I think, is more, you know, it's very in fashion with the 1930s where this story takes place. The hat also is a huge change. And she better have an umbrella in that other hand that I can't see. Although the bird on the umbrella that she talks to, of course, you know, famously at the end of the movie, seems to have migrated to her hat, which I think it would be a little hard to talk to up there. You can't look the bird in the eyes, right? Like, are we having a conversation or not? But I guess, you know, it's right next to her head, so they could talk. I do like, it's a little bit of a zoot suit kind of feel to it, too. I love the feathers, and I guess Mary Poppins would be, I don't know off the top of my head if zoot suit is appropriate for the times, but Mary Poppins, I'm sure, would be a little bit ahead of the curve, although considering all the heat that Emma Watson is taking for being a feminist, maybe Mary Poppins doesn't want to get anywhere near that. But she's always, you know, been very strong-willed, and so I like that she would not only be in the moment fashion-wise, but maybe, again, a little bit ahead of the curve. So it's certainly a lovely hat, but you know, the original Mary, it's weird, it's hard for me to get used to. You know, the bright blue gloves that match the scarf, that is crazy. Mary Poppins, you know, I always feel a little conservatively dressed. Now, you might be like, Grace, I'm looking at her in an orange suit with pink shoes. What the heck are you talking about? But, you know, that's very much still a style. You know, the pink's, you know, caught in the bow tie. I guess the gloves and the scarf is the same thing. But this seems a little bit bolder to me for some reason. So, you know, because I think that Mary Poppins is, again, I think the right word to use would be conservative. And this Mary Poppins certainly does not seem to be the case. The shoes are spot on, right? Even the way she's standing, I love it with her feet out. That's spectacular. She's got the Mary Poppins stance down. She looks, speaking of, you know, vanity and Mary Poppins, she looks very pretty. Emily Blunt looks great there. She looks also like she means business, as Poppins does. Poppins is tough. I love that about Poppins. And she looks, I think, suitably like Julie Andrews, which is also quite impressive. A lot of it's going to be in the performance, though, and the quality of her singing. She was very good in Into the Woods, though, so I'm rooting for her. Also, I'm surprised another reason they would change the hat is that this takes place when the books were actually written, and that's when Poppins had her trademark flower hat. So to get rid of it, that's another reason that it's surprising to do away with it. The colors are very beautiful, though. They'll certainly pop. Although, speaking of color, 17 Cherry Tree Lane seems to have seen brighter, more colorful days. I mean, look at the plant life on that thing. I mean, I believe Michael lives there now, and he is, you know, Mary Poppins is going to be, she's going to like, let's sing a song about the importance of landscaping, shall we, Michael? Because it's a mess. Also, I brought up these photos, as you can see, of fashion at the time. 1930s London, and this certainly does fit the bill. Her scarf is even tucked in, as these women did. Mary Poppins had hers out, you know, Victorian London, but you can see from those working women, the other women are a little fancier, but the working women in particular, as Mary Poppins is definitely a working woman, that just fits perfectly. The cape aspect to the coat, I couldn't find that mimicked anywhere. And, you know, it's a good thing Mary Poppins isn't wearing fur. I don't think even Poppins could survive that. But she looks very, very good. Very, a little different. It's an edgier look. I think that's maybe something that's off, because I can't quite put my finger on it. It doesn't have the softness of Julie Andrews' Mary Poppins. So this Poppins is probably, she's probably upset she had to come back. She's like, are you kidding me? I worked so hard on this house. We even made a movie about it, and you guys messed it all up. So I'm very curious to see what the story is. And next, of course, we'll want to get a look at Lin-Manuel Miranda and his version of Bert, Lamplighter Jack. So what do you think? How does Emily Blunt look to you? What do you think of the changes? Does this look like an updated Poppins? I think it looks not only like an updated Poppins stylistically, but that Poppins has also grown as a person. I'm very curious to see. So what do you think? Write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.